Let's talk now a bit about streaming and how that integrates into Spark. So Spark supports streaming. The idea here is that you have a continuous stream of RDDs. So you have basically batches of tuples that need to be processed. So we have our continuous input stream that goes into Spark streaming that then processes these batches. What is a batch? Well, a batch could be like 100, 1000, of these input tuples, and each input tuple is dealt with like being an independent RDD. It also supports checkpointing of states, which is necessary for stateful computation. In that sense, it provides fault tolerance. So an issue that you have with the data model is that you cannot access all the data, the whole set of data at a given time. So you can only access data from one interval, or you can specify a sliding window in which you can update the data. You can manipulate states using some new functions which are called update state by key, for example. This data model has the drawback that not all transformations and operations are available. Well, how would you ever do, for example, a for each operation when the stream of data is never ending? This operation would block forever in trying to do the operation. You can also never get the data using collect anymore. However, what you can do is that you can combine these RDDs with existing RDDs using, for example, transform. The workflow to build a Spark streaming application is to define the pipeline, which is basically our DAG and the control and the code and everything, and then we start it, and then it runs basically forever until we shut down this workflow. In this workflow, you can read streams from multiple sources like files, directories, TCP sources, and so on. So you have to make sure that the number of tags assigned is always bigger than the number of receivers. Otherwise, the program stagnates. So here we see an example how the streams will be processed. We have here the function flat map, which is similar to map, but it may produce more than one. It produces zero, one, or multiple outputs. And what we want to do is we take a line, a text line, and we want to split the line by white space. So basically extracting the individual words or tokens in a sentence. So we get as an input our lines as a stream. So we get the lines for a certain time period, from time 0 to 1, whatever the interval here is. Now we run the flat map operation and we get the words from time 0 to 1 as an output. And then we do the same for time 1 to 2 and so on. So these are basically each of these little batches here are our little micro batches that we are processing, and we can only see at a time them. And we never can see the whole data from time 0 to 4 in this example. As you can see, it's very natural. So you process the inputs from this interval, and then you get the outputs from this interval, which then can be fed into yet another compute operation. We can now run also some window-based operation, for example, reduction operations sometimes. For example, counting in a window of 30 seconds, we want to find out how often, how many words there are. So we can count writing a lambda function that sums up the number of words that we see, for example, and we say we create a window of 30 seconds, and for every 10 seconds it's applied. So how does this look like? Well, at a given time, at time 5, you look back basically 30 seconds, take this time, and then apply your operation on it to produce an output. But there is an overlap, because we say we want to run this every 10 seconds. So we run this again at time 4, we run it with time 4, 3, and 2, and at time 3, we run it at time 3, 2, and 1. So we get a little bit of overlap, but sometimes that might be really intentional, right? As a manager, you might be interested. So how many of these products have been sold the last 30 seconds? For example, when you do, when you air a commercial and a very prominent event like the Super Bowl, for instance, It might be really valid to see how are people reacting in the last 30 seconds to your ad. Are they making a purchase now? What's going on? Here is a more complex streaming application in which we take a TCP port from localhost, and we had to set up a streaming context, and then we define as an input we create a socket, so a TCP text stream from localhost. We split the stream using FlatMap into tokens, and then we create for each word that we find one. So we say word, comma one, so we count we get that we can know for each. We do pretty much our word count example again, right? So we have here a function that updates this word count, and we use our checkpointing features. We print a couple of tokens for each stream, IDD. And then we start the computation and it runs until it is terminated. Okay, so I submit this program and it will block until I stop my code. And now I can connect, for example, using Netcat to my localhost server. And you can see here I gave it input. This is a test. It outputs the first 10 tokens. This is one, test is one, A is one, is this one, because we counted it, right? Now I say I connect again. This is a house. Now this has occurred two times, test has occurred once, A two times, and so on. So that is already why it's very simple. You can see how we can use these concepts in a powerful app to create a powerful application for streaming.